Hi, I'm David with General Air. Have you ever wondered why when you're MIG welding thinner material like this 14 gauge here, that the puddle just pops through the other side? Well, today we're going to show you a few techniques to keep that from happening. This machine is a Multimatic 200. It can MIG weld, it can stick weld, it can weld flux core, and it can TIG weld. It's one of my favorite machines. The first technique I want to talk about is just the progression of how you weld a thinner coupon. Are you starting from the bottom and moving your way to the top, or are you starting from the top and moving your way to the bottom? Well, if you go vertical up, so from the bottom to the top, this is typically the result that you're going to get. Now, not only is our weld pretty terrible, there's a lot of buildup on it, but we burn through in about 5 different spots. So what happens now with all the same machine settings if we just change our progression and go vertical down? Now, as you can see, the bead looks a lot better. Because we went from the top to the bottom, we're able to move faster, spend less time on the weld itself. If you spend less time, put in less heat, less chance of burning through. Well, from what we saw with our last example, vertical down is a much better way to go. But now we're in a horizontal position. So does moving from right to left in a push technique or from left to right in a drag technique make a difference? Let's find out. This weld was welded using the push technique. So our wire and our arc were facing towards unwelded cold material as we moved down the line. And this weld was welded with the drag position. So the arc and the wire are faced back on the weld towards molten material. You wouldn't think that that would make too much of a difference, but you turn the coupon around, you'll see that the heat affected zone for the dragged weld is much larger than that of the pushed weld. So just changing the direction of travel down your material can prevent burn throughs. Something that I see welders do often with thinner material and that is incorrect is little circles as they move down the line. As you weld the small circles, you increase the amount of time it takes to get from point A to point B, increasing the amount of heat you put into the plate. Not only are burn throughs prevalent, but also just warping the plate in general. Better still, the technique of moving from point A to point B as fast as you can to get the smallest weld that's possible and reducing the amount of heat input. This weld, we use the circular motion as we welded down in the push technique. Now, I will admit it's a pretty good looking bead, but it's over welded. So if we look at the back side of the weld, there's no burn throughs, there's no holes, but definitely the arc got into these areas of the metal and the arc heat melted that, but it didn't fill it back in with filler. So those are all stress risers. And at the end of the day, this is just a weaker weld. This weld, we didn't employ any sort of circles or anything like that. We just went from point A to point B as fast as possible. Now, this bead doesn't look as good as the one that we did the circles on, but the more important thing is that the heat affected zone is less, there's less warpage in the plate, and most of all, there's not even a hint of burn through on the backside.